Okay, hello guys, this is me, Sasha again, and I'm so surprised that we have today a new tier 9, the second tier 9 weapons mod master variant, and I'm so excited to give you my recommendation and to tell you what I'm looking for the new tier 9 second one tier 9 Mod Master variant. So okay, let's don't waste the time because this is gonna be a bit longer video. So let's start with the assault rifles, which is represented with the AN-94. So as you may know, I already like this weapon very nice. It's very nice and I love it a lot because this new assault rifle comes with a lot damage first, the especially the Halloween version. So the usual configuration with reflex open 1x, so the fixed stock or whatever stock, it's up to you. Extended magazine for sure. So now I was looking for a grip variant. For sure I will go with a flash suppressor, maybe even with a silencer in some case, and a short barrel. So and for the demonstration, a Magnum ammo, and maybe you can try with some kind of the camo, and especially this one, the new weapon camo Terrapin, which I really like how this looks like, especially on this. So I was looking for something like the Mod Master variant for a CQC variant with a short barrel. And we have this pretty nice burst mod with two shot by one click, which is are very accurate. So actually the difference between the MK17 burst mod and this AN-94 is that those two shots are almost in the same spot comparing with the MK17, which are having three bullets, but they're not exactly into same spot. Something that I already mentioned in my Halloween variant gun review. So anyway, so this is what I was looking for. This could be a very nice CQC weapon of the AN-94 Mod Master variant. So basically this reminds me for the AK-12, which is have very very similar damage and fire rate. The short barrel variant, which is CQC, and after some buff, the accuracy is almost the same on the AK-12. And anyway, control is a bit similar. So, okay, let's speak about the AN-94, not for the AK. So this is tier 9 review and not tier 7. Of course, you can go with long barrel to achieve the Halloween variant, close to the Halloween. So there you're gonna lose a bit more damage. So actually not gonna lose, but the difference are the Mob Master have less to damage, the fire rate is the same, and just one accuracy, and I believe the just one control. I will check it later, but definitely this weapon perform very well. Very similar to the Halloween variant. So I'm pretty sure some of you already know how this weapon can kill. So anyway, the recoil, I believe we have more horizontal. Yes, but still performing on same spot. So So you can use, of course, something like short barrel and bipod, even for 6C. Kinda get more control, but keep in mind with a bipod, the aim spread after shooting becomes wider than a grip. But still, with short barrel and bipod, you can perform very well for distance shooting, especially on full auto and no concern for burst. So anyway, the damage fell drop off, you can try it for yourself as well. So definitely the mod master of the AN-94, it's worth and it's pretty nice. So let's move on the shotguns. This Mark 1, just give me a second, I would like to shut off the music. Maybe just a little bit. And I will close the sound effect and a bit now the mine. Okay, don't wanna waste your time. So the Mark 1, it's pretty nice shotgun. We have a lot of damage, 210 with the medium barrel, and very nice fire with, even with the medium barrel. So definitely, even you can go with this naked shotgun without any attachment, but for more control you have to go with the grip, and definitely with this muzzle brake. Of course, just a laser designator, and I'm not using for myself any scope or a shotgun. So about the stock, so there is a bit tricky moment. So if you would like to have less ready time, so for me the ready time after 1.2 patch, the ready time does not become something of a matter, like all the ready time it's less than a second, and even less than a half a second. So anyway, you can go with the cappet for very less ready time, or retractable for, I don't know, maybe kind of design purpose, because for me 2.0 of a seconds, it's not a big deal. Anyway, this weapon performed very nice even with a medium barrel. So just to check, we have 8 bullets. So in a body, we have 22 with a medium barrel and 35 in a head. So long barrel, pretty nice damage and pretty nice fire rate of 165, nice accuracy and control. Something that I was just trying to tell you, that definitely with this kind of configuration on Tomsk, you're gonna be very fast. But keep in mind, maybe you can't kill people with specific armor upgrades, and maybe with the specific armors, maybe like the heavy one, from one shot. Maybe you're gonna perform between 2 and 3, maybe in some cases 4, but definitely you're faster, like you're having instant shots. Let me just start running. Yeah, definitely instant shots. So, and long barrel, and something that you actually, a short barrel, and this is a semi, this is not auto shotgun, this is the semi, and this means that you have to perform a tap shooting. But definitely this fire rate, it's very fast, so it's feeling like auto shotgun. It doesn't matter, it is a semi. So, and of course with long barrel, this is kind of beast. And if you have this muzzle brake, definitely you can get a bit more control. And the iron sight, it's a bit clear, and the crosshair, it's a bit tiny. Have 37 in the head. Anyway, this muzzle brake can be taken from the regular store from time to time. It just appear on a promo. It is GRFS muzzle brake. Anyway, let's move on the Recon. So the Vector first, not the sniper rifle. So this is pretty famous and pretty amazing. SMGs. I already discussed about the extended magazine, where we do have only 30 bullets in the magazine, and for in some cases this fire rate actually shoots these bullets pretty fast. So about the stock, kinda it's up to you. Definitely I will not go, and I will not recommend to go with foldable stock. You're losing control. Definitely you need control. I know that having a higher fire rate, the recoil, it's not so much. You can try even with foldable, but maybe for design purpose I will stay with this one. Just looks more different. Anyway, grip for sure. So for me, I will go with flash suppressor, but for what kind of mod master configuration I'm looking for. So definitely I'm looking for a silencer, and maybe you can stay with a medium barrel because you're gonna have a thousand fire rate, 75 accuracy, which is pretty nice, and 42 control, but you don't have so much damage. It's 34. Maybe you can Magnum, you can compensate, but definitely for me the Mod Master recommendation for the Mod Master variant, which I'm looking for, is gonna be a long barrel and a silencer. There is two reasons. First, I'm gonna have a 36 of a damage with the silencer. Second, the for me the fire rate between 900 and 1000, there is not so much difference. I know that when you got a short barrel, you have 1100, and actually it's 1100 the fire rate, but for me there is not so much feeling of difference between those fire rate, but it's up to you. And still you have more accuracy, which is for a hip fire, it's also pretty nice. About the camo, it's up to you. I still like this terpian, maybe some blue, or I don't know. Anyway, all of those are great for me. So the Vector with long barrel and silencer perform very well, and this is the hip fire, pretty nice. Let's just check the recoil. Not so huge. Yeah, we have high fire rate, and the horizontal, it's very very close spots, not so much, but a bit more vertical, but more horizontal. Anyway, so pretty nice SMG guys. The drop of damage, of course you can check it by yourself. We have only auto and semi bot, so it's up to you, but this is my kind of Mod Master variant recommendation, which I would be looking for. Anyway, the sniper rifle, it's a very very amazing. So for me, such a kind of sniper rifle, I will go with Sniper 6X. It's not comfortable for a lot of people, but for me it's okay, because I would use such kind of sniper rifle mostly for CQC and short distance shooting, like up to medium. But we have a lot of damage, of course, extended magazine, so this sniper rifle will perform very well for long range shooting. So feel free to go with a bipod, of course, but in some cases I'll stick with a grip and maybe kind of silencer, but in some cases I'll stick with a muzzle brake just to achieve more control. So to be or not to be, anyway, for me this sniper rifle is very nice with a lot of possibilities of configuration. I can go with a short barrel. This looks more not like sniper rifle, I could say. This is more like some different type weapon. Anyway, so I would go with a silencer like maybe this one. For demonstration purpose, I need this Magnum ammo. So just checking the settle time, guys. Guys, the settle time, it's the most important criteria for sniper rifles in some cases, not in all, but the settle time is where your aim spread are going closer, how fast this aim spread going to be closed. Just look at this white crosshair, how fast will go into the middle of my screen, into the middle of the scope. So anyway, you can't expect with kind of configuration, but some kind of decent body shot, but still in most cases you might gonna get down assault with two shots in a body, maybe in some cases with three, very depends on what kind of armor and armor upgrades does it have. So anyway, just as I said, this kind of configuration maybe only for stance shooting. Still very interesting. This is a, hold on, I said short barrel. This is auto sniper rifle, and as you can see, we have a benefit of no rolling animation, and we still have pretty nice damage. And the fire rate actually does not feel like auto shot, auto sniper rifle. I'm so sorry, I'm a bit tired already, as I said. And it's kind of like a regular one sniper rifle. Anyway, this is auto semi, that's why maybe. Of course, you can go with some kind of different sniper scope, which is more comfortable for you. For me, it's for me the other one comfortable sniper scope. It's 3 up to 9 because it's a bit wider than the up to 12. Of course, I would go with the bipod and long barrel and maybe some kind of muzzle brake or whatever for to achieve more control. So definitely the settle time, there is a bit delay in the settle time, and it is noticeable comparing long and short barrel. So definitely, guys, it's up to you. But so I believe that in some cases you might gonna take down a support and recon with a one shot in a body. I said one shot, but assault definitely would be mitigate in most cases the body shot, so you have to keep in mind that head is your aim. Definitely you have to go only for headshots. Of course, you can perform even with grip and long barrel, so. And also short barrel with a bipod, the settle time would be still lower than comparing with a long barrel. Okay, so enough for the sniper rifle, and let's move on with the not Mark One. Let's move on with the M240 MLG, which for me becomes favorite MLG right now, and the Mod Master have kinda interesting possibility. So it's up to you if you're going to play with M96 Dash or M240. Both are pretty nice MLGs, just I believe that the M240 have more fired with a short barrel. Yes, it's the same as the Helin. It's 770, but we don't have the same damage of 58, but still 55, it's pretty nice. The scope, it's up to you. You can go, of course, with the bipod in with short barrel for maybe in CQC situation. So definitely, I will go with the flash suppressor. But you may also try with this MB-FS 012-T muzzle brake, which will give you more control, and the flashes are going on the horizontal, will not flash on the vertical, which still give you some kind of visibility. Of course, reflex open 1x and all the usual stuff. For a purpose, for a demonstration purpose, I'll use the Magnum ammo. So, to be honest, I was looking for and I was interesting to in a grip variant for a kind of CQC, but we're gonna have very less control. But for Tomsk, I believe this kind of gonna be very nice. Maybe, I'm not quite sure, because I've been performing very well with the Helin variant, which have a bipod by default. So definitely the wall control is noticeable, and still you have to keep in mind that this MLG is jumpy. So anyway, maybe with the bipod. Still this MLG is jumpy. So anyway, let me just try the recoil. Wow, we have more vertical than horizontal. So, pretty interesting configuration. Is don't it's okay, just I would try to save first, but the very interesting configuration, long barrel, but don't miss the medium barrel. I'll say later why. So, what do we have with the long barrel? We have the extremely 69 damage and pretty nice fire rate for such MLG with very nice accuracy and control. Of course, you can even perform anyway flash suppressor for me for sure. So, two shots. Almost everything is down. Wow, we have 140, 95. We have 169. Anyway, on full auto with short barrel, I noticed that this does not perform very well on long distance, but for medium distance, still still shooting very well, but on long distance I don't like so much. So for long distance you still have to perform kind of tap shooting or just make 2-3 shots and then make small pause and then shoot again. So this is very nice long range. I've tried with the Phantom, but to be honest I don't like still how does it perform on long range with such a scope. As you can see, still is jumpy. And even on medium distance, does not perform very well, still jumpy. So for me, reflex open 1x. So as I said, you can go with the medium because you still have 59 damage and 700 fire rate. Most of the assault rifle actually have even less than a 700 fire rate, and even they still perform pretty nice in CQC. So maybe with the medium barrel you can perform in CQC action as well. And of course this is gonna be pretty nice for sorry, I forgot my words, for medium and long distance shooting. But you have to keep in mind that this weapon still jumpy. Wow, two same amount of critical damage. It was kind of fun. Okay, just there is last but not at least. So the headguns. Why I switched to recons? Because the judge is the first friend of the snipers. So definitely if you're a sniper and you love to play sniper, or just you're switching from time to time from SMG to sniper, the judge is definitely your best second friend in situation where you found yourself to playing in a CQC where some kind of opponent's enemy comes very close to you. So this is your mini shotguns, still perform very well. So of course you can try, you can have it for support or assault. Definitely this is kind of very interesting and very nice secondary weapon. It's pretty nice with so much damage. Definitely it's kind of shotgun. Still the accuracy, it's lower, it's similar to the shotgun, and you have just 5 bullets, but still this damage, it's pretty crazy. So I hope you guys found this video useful. Thanks for watching, and if you have some additional questions or you feel that you have to post your comment, make sure to be below the video, below this video, and I will try to respond there and of course give you answers. So thanks guys for watching and see you next time.